Hello everybody. Today I have come up with the summary on unit number 6, which consists of resistance temperature coefficient, insulation resistance and work power energy. As you can see here, this is a graph for resistance versus temperature for a typical metal. As the temperature increases, the resistance also increases. We can define RTC, which is nothing but it can be given as the change in resistance per ohm, original resistance per degree centigrade, change in the temperature from the given temperature. So this is the way we can define RTC. We can also define RTC, that is resistance temperature coefficient, as the ratio of change in resistance per degree centigrade, change in temperature, to the resistance at T degree centigrade or 0 degree centigrade. The unit for RTC is per degree centigrade. We will start with the basic definition for RTC on the slide. You can see the graph for resistance versus temperature, which we have already discussed in the previous slide. Now we will move towards the derivation of alpha 2 in terms of alpha 1. The initial starting position will be from R2 in terms of R1. R2 is equal to R1 into bracket 1 plus alpha 1 T2 minus T1, and R1 will be equal to R2 into bracket 1 plus alpha 2 T1 minus T2. We have got these two simultaneous equations. We will be going with the substitution method to get alpha 2 in terms of alpha 1. The final equation that we will get after the derivation is alpha 2 is equal to alpha 1 divided by 1 plus alpha 1 into bracket T2 minus T1. We can also formulate alpha T, which is alpha at any temperature T, which is equal to alpha 0 divided by 1 plus alpha 0 into T. So if we know a value of alpha 0, we can find out the value of alpha at any temperature T or vice versa. We will be proceeding with the list of formula on the next slide. We will be proceeding with the list of formulas that are required to solve the numericals on this topic. Formula number 1 to formula number 8 are general formulas that are required for this particular chapter. From formula number 9, you will get the formulas for RTC, which you need to remember. So formula number 9, 10, 11 and 12 and 13 are the formulas for RTC. These are very essential to solve the numericals on RTC. As you know, the value of resistance changes with the temperature. Similarly, there is the effect on resistivity also. You get the formula for rho at any degree temperature T, which is equal to rho at 0 in bracket 1 plus alpha 0 into T. Similarly, you can write rho 2 will be equal to rho 1 into bracket 1 plus alpha 1 bracket T2 minus T1. After that, you have the formulas for composite conductor. Composite conductor is made up of two different materials. When two different materials are connected together, let me say the material, first material has resistance R1. Its value is alpha 1 at T1, and we have the second material which has resistance R2 and alpha 2 as its RTC at temperature T2. So we can write the formula for composite conductor, RTC of a composite conductor, which is equal to R1 into alpha 1 plus R2 into alpha 2 divided by R1 plus R2. So, if a numerical comes on a composite conductor, you can use the formula R1 alpha 1 plus R2 alpha 2 divided by R1 plus R2, which will be the RTC for a composite conductor. Let's get started with the numerical that may come from RTC. Now, here I have taken a typical numerical where a copper wire has a temperature coefficient of 1 upon 254.5 per degree centigrade at 20 degree centigrade, and find the temperature coefficient at 0 degree centigrade and 60 degree centigrade. We are aware about the formula of alpha T in terms of alpha 0. We know that alpha T is equal to alpha 0 divided by 1 plus alpha 0 into T. Using the formula, we can find out the value of alpha 0 in the initial state, and then we can find out the value of alpha at 60 degree centigrade. So this is the way we can deal with this numerical. This numerical may be asked for 2 marks. Let's go to the next numerical, where at 0 degree Celsius, a specimen of copper wire has its resistance 4 milliohm and its resistance is 1 upon 234.5 per degree Celsius. Find the value of its resistance and alpha at 70 degree centigrade. So here the value of alpha 0 is given and the value of resistance is given. You need to find out the value of R, that is resistance, at 70 degree and the value of alpha at 70 degree. You can go with the formula R2 is equal to R0 into bracket 1 plus alpha 0 into T2 minus T1. From that you will get the value of R at 70, that is resistance value at 70 degree C. And you can also go with the formula as alpha at 70, which is equal to alpha at 0, divided by 1 plus alpha 0 in bracket T2 minus T1. Here the value of T1 is nothing but 0. So this two numerical, again this numerical may be asked for 2 marks. One more numerical based on RTC. A resistance element having a cross section area of 10 mm square and length of 10 meter takes a current of 4 ampere from 220 volt supply at a temperature 20 degree C. Find resistivity and current it will take when the temperature rises to 60 degree Celsius. Now the value of alpha at 20 is given, which is equal to 0.003 per degree Celsius. The area is given and the length required for the resistance element is also given. It is given that it takes a current of 4 ampere when the voltage applied is 220 volts. So at 20 degree centigrade, we can find out the value of resistance R, which is equal to V upon I. So V is 220 volt divided by 4 will be the resistance at 20 degree C. We need to find out the value of resistivity. We are aware about the formula for resistance. R is equal to rho into L upon A. We have found out the value of resistance by the formula V upon I. From that we can get the value of resistivity rho, which will be equal to resistance into area divided by length. In the next part of the problem, the current is required to be found out when the temperature rises to 60 degree centigrade. We know that R2 will be equal to R1 into bracket 1 plus alpha 1 bracket T2 minus T1. Here T1 is 20 degree centigrade and T2 is 60 degree centigrade. R1 we have already found out. We need to find out the value of R2. Once we get the value of R2, we can find out the value of I2, which will be equal to V upon R2. On this slide, we have the definition for insulation resistance, which is nothing but the resistance offered by the insulating material to the flow of leakage current through it. We denote insulation resistance with capital R suffix I, that is we call it as RI, which is equal to V upon IL, where V is the voltage between the conductor and earth and IL is the leakage current. The practical value of RI is very very high and it lies in terms of mega ohms. The typical insulators are air, glass, mica, porcelain, rubber, oil and varnish. The resistance of the insulating materials decreases with the increase in temperature, that is, they have negative temperature coefficient. Also, moisture content has effect on the insulation resistance. If the moisture increases, the value of Ri decreases. In the derivation, we can see that the final value of Ri, which is equal to rho upon 2 pi L log E R2 upon R1, where R1 is the resistance of conductor and R2 is the resistance of conductor plus the thickness of insulation. An important point to be remembered is the value of insulation resistance is inversely proportional to the length, while the value of resistance in case of the conductor is directly proportional to the length. This slide shows a typical example on underground cables, cable A and cable B, which have different resistances, that is conductor resistance and different insulation resistance. RA, that is the conductor resistance, is 0.6 ohm for cable A, and the conductor resistance for B is 0.8 ohm. Similarly, the insulation resistance for cable A is 600 mega ohms and the insulation resistance for cable B is 400 mega ohm. The formulation is asked that if these cables are connected in series and if these are connected in parallel, what would be their resultant conductor resistances and resultant insulation resistance. An important point to be noted is if the cables are connected in series, then their conductor resistance will be in series, but their insulation resistance will appear in parallel. So, if these cables A and B are connected in series, the conductor resistance, the total conductor resistance will be 0.6 plus 0.8, so it will be equal to 1.4 ohm. And the total insulation resistance will be like they are appearing in parallel, and the parallel equivalent resistance is given as RA into RB divided by RA plus RB, that is nothing but 600 into 400 divided by 600 plus 400. So that will be the insulation resistance, effective insulation resistance, if these cables are connected in series. Similarly, if these two cables are connected in parallel, then their insulation resistance will be in series and their conductor resistance will be in parallel. So if the cables are connected in parallel, the value of insulation resistance will be 600 mega ohm plus 400 mega ohm, and their conductor resistance will be 0.6 into 0.8 divided by 0.6 plus 0.8. These are the important things to be remembered with respect to the numericals on cables connected in series and cables connected in parallel. Let's see one more last numerical on a single core cable. It is given as that a single core copper cable has a conductor diameter of 3 cm and insulation thickness of 2 cm. The resistivity of copper and insulating material are 1.73 into 10 raised to minus 8 ohm meter and 9 into 10 to the power 12 ohm meter respectively. Determine the resistance of conductor and insulator for the cable of 150 meter length. So the given things are diameter D1 is given, which is equal to 3 cm, that is nothing but 0.03 meter. The resistivity of copper is given, which is 1.73 into 10 to the power minus 8 ohm meter. Resistivity of insulating material is given, which is equal to 9 into 10 to the power 12 ohm meter. Length is given, which is 150 meter. We can find out the value of resistance for the conductor, that is copper, which is nothing but rho into L upon A. So we can take the value of resistivity as 1.73 into 10 to the power minus 8 into 150 divided by pi r square, where r is nothing but the value of R1, which we will take depending upon the value of D1 specified in the numerical. Similarly, when we are doing with the insulation resistance, finding out the value of insulation resistance, Ri is given as rho upon 2 pi L ln R2 upon R1. Here we will take the value of resistivity as resistivity of the insulating material, which is specified in the numerical as 9 into 10 to the power 12. So that we will be considering to find out the value of Ri. We will get the value of resistance for conductor and we will get the value of resistance for insulating material Ri. Ri comes out to be 8.09 into 10 to the power 9 ohms. While taking the value of Ln R2 upon R1, R1 is given in the numerical, like D1 is given, so from that we can find out the value of R1, which will be half of the value of D1. D1 is the diameter given and we need for the value of R1, so D1 divided by 2 will be R1, and to find out the value of R2 we will have to consider the thickness. So the value of R1, which is equal to 0.015 plus the thickness of insulation, which is equal to 2 cm. So we will get that value of R2, which is equal to 0.035. That is the way we will be doing with this numerical.